Students often come up with a doubt as to which strategy to follow, and I guess Mr. Atul is one of the best person to tell you this because he himself cleared NABARD exam few months back. And the second problem that often students have is the work profile and the work culture. So without wasting any further time, let's go and talk with Mr. Atul. So Atul, welcome to the channel. Before starting with the question answer series, it would be great if you could introduce yourself to the viewers.
Hi, myself Atul Yadav. I belong to Itawa, Uttar Pradesh. I have done my BTech in Information Technology back in 2015. After that, I have worked in an IT firm in Noida for 4 years. And this year, I have cleared this NABARD Grade A exam.
So Atul, how it feels to be a NABARD Grade A officer?
I mean, it feels great to be part of, you know, such a good organization. NABARD has a very good name. It has a lot of respect to its name because, you know, it works for the most vulnerable section of the society. You need to work direct. You can work directly at the ground level. You can serve the rural people. And that in itself is a, you know, very good satisfaction that you get. Other than that, in terms of, you know, monetary things, it pays you well. And it is paying you for things that, you know, you can only do in NGOs or something. You are getting paid for doing the social work. So this is a very good thing. Other than in monetary terms, I mean, you are getting paid very well. There are a lot of perks. You get, you know, I mean, your whole life is secure in terms of medical, maybe in terms of tours and travel. So it's a great organization.
Atul, have you ever thought that you're gonna clear NABARD Grade A exam?
To be frank, I would say no, because I would go like to back to my, you know, engineering days when I completed my BTech. So I was not in any mood to, you know, to go for any of the government exams. But down the line, after two, three years of working in the private sector, I mean, I saw some cons there. So that's why I moved to this key. I have to move to some government exam. So I had some interest in economics and, you know, finance in particular. So NABARD Grade A and RBI Grade B was the obvious choice for me. So first time I attempted this exam in 2018, that time I was not very aware about the, you know, kind of syllabus or the kind of questions they ask. So I was not able to clear that time. And then I realized that the competition is very tough. You know, I mean, there are a lot of people, those who are appearing for this exam, particularly, you know, after this 2015. So then I realized that, I mean, this exam is not very easy as I was thinking earlier. So after that, I mean, this year I, you know, focused. I mean, I did my preparation in a very focused way after looking at the syllabus, exactly what is required. If you see this exam, you know, from the, you know, on other side, you know, from the those aspirant side who are appearing for this, it seems very tough. Because there are a lot of people who are appearing for this. But once you, you know, prepare in a focused way and you clear this exam, then only you realize that it wasn't that much tough. So one major thing I would say that is stopping students from clearing this exam is that, you know, you don't believe in yourself that you can clear this exam. One positive thing on my side was that I was working as well. So I didn't really have to think about the, you know, the financial thing and everything, and I was not having very much of pressure that I have to clear this exam. That works in a positive sense, because once you do not worry about that thing, you can clearly focus on the exam. So one thing I would want everyone to you know, be very clear about is that once you are totally focused and you are sure in your mind that you have to clear this exam, half of, you know, the way is done, irrespective of your background you came from. Because, I mean, it is more of a generalist kind of exam. They are seeking generalists in this exam. So you need not to worry about your background. If you are totally focused, you are totally clear in your mind that you have to clear this, I mean, the way becomes very easy.
So Atul, my next question is, you are from an engineering background and were working in IT sector. So what pushed you to get into banking sector and leaving your engineering field?
So I have a very positive aspect to it. I think IT sector is something that is always a bonus irrespective of the field you are in. It is becoming more of an enabling sector for all the other sectors. So I never thought of this as something as a drastic change, or I have left my engineering roots behind. engineering has given me rational thinking about everything, and that always will come handy. It's just that in the back of my head, I had a knack for finance and economics, so I went for these exams. It's better to do something that you like, rather than doing something that you have to.
Atul, many students are confused whether to write the exam or not because they don't have the clarity as how the organization is and what their roles and responsibilities will be. Since you have already joined the NABARD, could you please throw some light on this aspect?
I was also in the same state earlier, but for me so far it has been a great experience. Once you go into NABARD, then only you realize the wide gamut of work that it offers. You get the first-hand experience of how policies are being worked upon. There are a wide array of departments as well. I'm still in that phase of exploration. There are departments for economic analysis which are working on various problems like, better price realization for farmers, price fluctuations. There are various departments for microfinance as well, figuring out why there is regional disparity in the reach of microfinance. NABARD is also working on various initiatives for furthering financial inclusion. So, there is a lot of quality work that you can do in NABARD.
Atul, this was your second attempt. In the first attempt, you were not able to make it through. So what changes or strategy you changed this time which helped you to clear the exam?
So actually the last time when I appeared for this exam, I was not at all prepared. I was, just getting into that mood that to understand this exam, what kind of questions they ask, what is the syllabus. So I would say that was more of a false kind of attempt. So this time for prelims, I only prepared for current affairs, economics, social issues and agriculture. For current affairs, I followed various capsules that are available online. Along with that, I read newspapers on daily basis for those 4-5 months for understanding of ongoing issues and, the various reports that appear in newspapers. Most of the economics and social issues questions are covered when you read the static part associated with the current affairs. For agriculture, a lot of aspirants consider this as a very difficult part. I downloaded the syllabus and selected some key topics only because I think the cost benefit associated with reading the whole of agriculture is not that much. So I selected some key topics only like soil, breeds of animals, common crops, their requirement. I made note of all these by copy-pasting various articles from the internet. And especially I would like to mention Tamil Nadu Agriculture University website. There all these things are in a very comprehensive, and consolidated manner. For computer science, I needed no extra reading because, I am from IT background. For quants and reasoning, I try to look for easy questions first and not go for the time-consuming ones because, the time is very limited. Good thing about prelims is that it's just a qualifying exam. You can score high in the sections that you are strong in and just clear, the marks for the rest of the sections.
And Atul, what about phase 2? How did you prepare for it?
Yeah, so I studied for both the phases simultaneously. Most of the parts or syllabus is very overlapping. For prelims, you need to focus more on the factual aspect. While for phase 2, you also need to understand the issues and static things that are associated with them. For ESI, I covered the static parts of economics from videos of Brunel that are available online. I complemented them with the notes that I made out of the newspapers. I used to read newspaper on daily basis and extract any information available, various reports that come in newspapers and any other information, and used to consolidate them. And I used to revise that multiple times. I also read economics and social issues section from Vision IAS as well. For agriculture, I would say there is no clear-cut strategy as such. I made notes on various topics that are there in the syllabus from Google itself, from PIB of Agriculture Ministry, and then from Tamil Nadu Agriculture University website, and then consolidated them and revised them multiple times. Yeah, and one thing I would say is that I was fortunate enough, to have some friends, those were preparing along with me. So we used to share all these things, that some would prepare news from the notes from the newspapers, other would collect the PIB articles, and in the last phase, for the English part, We also, you know, wrote 6-7 essays on various topics that were currently going. And luckily, we also got, you know, there was one essay from that topic itself in the paper. So if you have some friends along with you, those are who are preparing, then, you know, it becomes easy for you.
You scored 21 out of 25 in your interview round. So how did you prepare? Can you tell our viewers?
So I would say interview is more about your personality, but yeah, there is still scope. You can up to some extent guide the direction in which you want your interview to go. Before interview, they ask you for a DAF. Make sure that you fill that very carefully and be smart when you fill it. Just because you have some good certificate, you know, in some sports, you need not to write it, because then you have to know everything about that game, because they may ask you any questions. Being an agriculture and rural financing institution, they always can ask for agriculture related things of your area, like major crops or any issues that are pertaining to your district or area, or any recent changes in policies. Also, if you are a working professional, you should prepare basic things which some other might know about your profession. Example, being an IT engineer, they asked me about Internet of Things, about artificial intelligence as well, and there were a lot of questions that were associated to my work. You also need to be thorough with, you know, various online portals that are there in NABARD. You need to be thorough with their website or whatever public information that is available about NABARD. You should be thorough with it, because they might ask any question based on that. So I think that was my strategy.
Speed and accuracy plays a very important part in competitive examination. So Atul, how did you hold that pressure of maintaining the speed and accuracy?
So for speed and accuracy, I would say there is no strategy as such. The only strategy is practice and practice. Because if you know, if you can prepare yourself beforehand for the situation that you're gonna be in that exam, so I mean that is the key. Mocks are very important to ensure speed and accuracy in the exam. Once you practice a lot of mocks, it becomes easy for you, you know, in the exam not to panic, because there is very limited time. So I think that is my strategy, practice and practice.
So Atul, my last question is, many aspirants have the myth and fear that UPSC or agricultural background students hold upper hand in the exam. What is your view?
So if you see the question paper, it is mostly, you know, based on current affairs and the static questions based on, you know, those things. If you follow current affairs religiously and you have basic understanding of economics or, you know, all the concepts, I think then you are at par with all the UPSC people, because, you know, you need not to know everything the way UPSC people does. For agriculture, the cost benefit of delving too much into agriculture is not there. Very basic questions are asked, and that too from very basic topics like soil, you know, breeds of animals and crop patterns. So I think that could be handled. I don't think, you know, there is any advantage, because, you know, they hardly ask questions for say 10 or 15 marks in the exam.
So Atul, thanks a lot for sharing your strategy and views with us. This is a small gift from our side. Hope you will like it.
Yeah, thank you very much.